Good morning everyone and welcome to this new video. This video again will be a bit different because it's weekend and we are in weekend mode. We've just had breakfast. What I'm going to do today is to make some meringues. Why? Because I love them. And besides being a great artist, I'm also a loving husband. And I asked myself, why not taking you with me? So if you're interested in one of my most favorite cakes, dishes for coffee, I suggest you watch this video and follow me along. And in case you're not interested in making some meringues, then just click the next one. So, and it wouldn't be me if I wouldn't add some artist twist to my meringues, and I'm going to make them somewhat colorful. So I'm going to put you on my camera easel in my kitchen, so another point of view for you as well. And yeah, guide you through the steps that I normally do to make my meringues. They are pretty easy to follow as well. And yeah, make one yourself. It's really delicious and it's fun. So join me. This is our kitchen. I've displayed everything that we're going to need. I will tell you something on the go. I hope I'm not too often within the camera frame so that you can see everything that I'm doing. And yeah, just have fun. So what we're actually going to need for the meringues is just this setup. This is a mixing machine. In case you do not have something like that, you can just use the old regular handheld version, which is this one. It will take a bit longer, but overall, everything will be fine. You'll need, of course, some eggs, which you're going to need to separate the egg yolks from the egg white. This is why I also have a cup here to separate them. You want to make sure that you do not have any egg yolk at all in your egg white, because otherwise you're not going to have this foamy stuff that you want to get in the very end. Everything will mix up, but it will not really get stiff and doesn't keep its structure. As we are artists, we want to go colorful and therefore have some food coloration. You of course going to need some Puderzucker. Well, you can actually use just regular sugar that you have available in the kitchen as well, or it works just better with the icing powder sugar, I don't know how you call it. This is the bowl for the sugar. You're going to need a scale. And this is because the recipe is really simple. You're going to need double the size of sugar that you have egg white. Nothing else, just that. And as a small tip, before you start creating, use some vinegar in a kitchen towel and clean all your materials, just to get rid of all probably greasy residue that you have on your kitchen equipment. This again will help you getting this great foamy egg white in the end. Step number one, separating the eggs. So, and therefore, what we're going to need is just one package of this powder sugar. We want to have our egg white fluffy white, therefore I'm going to use my kitchen machine, put it just in. And let it do the work for me. So, and once this is beaten up for a bit foamy consistency, you're going to add the sugar bit by bit. And you're ready to go when your foam does have these streaks here and looking so, and it looks stable like here. So this is how it's consistency to work with. Now let's come to the fun part. This you can actually do during this whole stuff is mixing, but if I told you, you couldn't hear me. So this is what you're going to do now. And therefore you're going to use the food coloration. So, and therefore just use the colors and put them into your squeezy bag that you will need in the very end. And this is how it looks like in the end. I normally do not want to have too much blobs of big paint in certain areas, so I'm going to use just a regular brush, use a clean one of course, and spread it around a bit just to have the color a bit more, yeah, spread it. And then for the final part you just need some non-sticking baking paper. You prepare a squeezing bag and your mixture. And once this part is done, you just put them into your preheated oven at 150 degrees Celsius for about 20-25 minutes. Then shut off the temperature and let it sit there for about an hour or so to have them completely readily baken. And here they are. Super cute, super pretty, and colorful. Actually, you know when they're ready when you can lift them off without everything sticking to the paper. And if you tap them, you can hear a somewhat hollow sound, which tells you they are ready. So, time has come for a coffee. I hope you enjoyed this video, although it was a bit different than my regular videos. And if you make some yourself, let me know how much you enjoy making them and how much you love them. And other than that, I wish you a great afternoon, a great weekend, and see you very soon. Bye bye!